Inside the Cave.
You did say you wanted to be in, right?
Hey, what up, JoJo?
What's good?
Man, we going wrong, man. No,
I don't do all that, though.
No email.
Hey, you might as well kick the show off like that. You might as well kick it off just like that. I'm going. We back and we raw.
We back and we raw. You know what I'm saying? We gonna give it to you like you've been getting it every morning. What's up, everybody? This is Inside the Cave. Welcoming y'all back to listening to us. Welcoming us back to giving it to you in the raw. I got two of the Inside the Cave podcast co-hosts with me. To my left, I got International D, better known as Stateside D right now, because he's back home, y'all. Welcome him back. What's up, D?
What's going on, Fly? Yeah, this International D, and right about now, I don't know if I want to be International D or Stateside D. Ain't nowhere to be D right now.
Man, I hear you, boy. Man, I hear you. That's some real shit. That is some real shit. How you and the family doing?
All is good, man. Just down here hanging out in Florida, you know. These folks act like ain't nothing going on down here. Folks at the beach like ain't nothing popping. But,
I was like, they didn't give up spring break. They didn't give up spring break for y'all, huh?
Hell no. Man.
No, they closed the bars and people got they got their drinks on the beach now.
Ain't that a bitch.
They need to go down there and fumigate the beach now. And spray all them motherfuckers.
Shit, it's spring break. Beach always need to be fumigated during spring break. If it ain't right, that voice, what else you gonna catch?
That voice you guys hear, ladies and gentlemen, that is Joe Dirt back in the house. Joe's in the house for the coronavirus podcast segment. What up, Joey?
Hey, what's going on, man? What's going on, everybody out there?
Hey, man, I know you got something for us, Joe. Like we gonna give it to the fans in the raw. Like, what's the raw shit that rawest, realest, funniest shit that you done seen in the past few days?
The craziest shit is watching Donald Trump, dumbass, talking about how it's not a pandemic, but now it was a pandemic before it was a pandemic. He talking about it wasn't all that serious and everything. Then they showed him again. He was like, "Yeah, I thought I knew it was a pandemic before it was a pandemic." Like, man, sit your ass down. I think he got the coronavirus.
I do too. I actually do. From what everybody's saying, if you've been around somebody with it and your ass getting it, you know what I'm saying? He talking about he ain't got it. Like the whole part of it. I think you got it.
Right. That Trump ain't black. Dude, he
100% stupid. That's stupid. I don't know if you guys caught the press conference today where he's like, let me get this quote correct. He said, people are dying that never died before.
Yeah.
I said, what? People are dying that never died before. Oh, man. Yo, that shit, yeah, that's the deal. He cannot hold office. Not for that one statement. Grab him by the pussy all you want. All this other crazy shit. Don't show your text. People are dying that never died before. That's some real zombie shit.
Yeah, that dude off the chain, man.
But you know, he still got his true followers, man. We just got done talking about spring break down here and all these people ignoring this and everything. Florida is still Trump territory, man. They swear about him. He can't do no wrong. He can't say no wrong. No matter what, they still got his back.
Yeah.
So we still got some base. We still got these dummies in this country right now. They're just stuck on stupid. And then at the same time, though, we can't really say much because, you know, look at the battle between Bernie and Joe Biden right now, whatever. As much as I want to support him, it's like they keep doing dumb shit too.
Yeah, that's over. Joe Biden don't want it.
So. Well, I know Joe Biden don't want it. You know, actually, he did get my respect on that shit that happened in the damn auto plant where dude came at him about, you know, about the guns and everything, yeah. and Biden about chewed his ass off. He said, "You a dumbass." He's like, "That ain't what I said." What do you call him when he walked away? Yeah, called him something. He called him something when he walked away, Joe. What do you call him? He taught him a horse's ass.
That's the old white man speak.
That's definitely a jackass. That's definitely a jackass.
You're a horse's ass. Like, damn, man. You know you're being recorded, right?
The political coverage is hard. Like, you know, Bernie's being, I don't know what to say, Bernie's being stubborn, or he's just trying to get some more promises from Biden for the Bernie supporters before he starts to support Biden. I mean, I just want one horse in the race so everybody can put their money on that one horse to go ahead and get this over with. If they keep going at it, they seem to be giving Trump more fuel to use against them when it comes time, by the time they get to the Democratic convention. If we're going to have a DNC, you know, with what's going on, you know, so the mandate and things that are happening with this amount of crowd, this amount of people, funerals, weddings, social gatherings, the shit makes you really rethink a whole bunch of shit. Like, you don't want to be in the house getting cabin fever, but I guarantee you don't want to go out and be around a bunch of people.
It's crazy because if this continue, they already kind of stopping some of the polls and stuff for the Democrat, you know, for the Democratic nomination. What you think they're going to do for the presidential nomination? He tried to pull one of them things that Putin over there pulling.
Man, like, you know, I don't think it's ever been done in history when election has been put off. A presidential election has been put off.
They're not going to put it off. They're not. If you think about it, look at how this plays out, though. If you looked at the polls right now, they're talking about how people are reacting. Democrats are more worried about the Democrats are the ones that are freaking out about the coronavirus, like, more so than the Republicans. Have you looked at Fox News? You know, look at your press. Man, I just flipped to it to see what dumbass shit they're saying. And they're like, they still somehow, you got people still blaming this shit on the Democrats. You know, it's just stupidity or whatever. But, you know, Republicans, they keep feeding them bullshit, and they keep buying into it instead of, you know, that's why you still got people running the streets down here, because they're not taking this as serious as it is. You know, until it hit home and it hit somebody's house and somebody dying from it in their house, it's not hitting home yet. And then this stimulus package right now, you got all these people, you know, drinking the Kool-Aid right now about this $1,000 that he's about to pump into people's pockets. What the hell $1,000 gonna do for you?
Don't do exactly. If you think about it, it's $250 a week. What can you do with that? That's probably what, one or two bills. You ain't finna. Yeah. I mean, but they ain't gonna spend it on that.
Dude, we about absolutely to lose not. We about to lose the airlines again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Think about all the people who got jobs there. You know. But the good thing, the only good thing I can say about all of this is, what's the one thing that's keeping his numbers up? And that's the finances, because he's swerving down. He got the country going in the right direction. Well, now he fucking with people money, because I seen my stocks lately and everything is in the red.
Right.
Everything is crashing right now. You mess with people money, that's it. Like I told you boys earlier, unless you got stock in these companies that's making this antivirus, you might as well leave it alone. I sold my airline stock today because I was like, this pointless right here. I'm tired of watching my money fly away.
Yeah, I did. I sold off some stock on Monday. I think Friday and Monday, I sold off some stock. This one, ain't no sense of holding on to it. You know,
grab that shit later.
Like, even Bitcoin was down like more than 50%. That shit went from $9,000 to, I think it definitely was like $4,200 or some shit like that.
Yeah, that
fucking high. Man, the Bitcoin was $9,000 for one share. And that shit dropped on Monday. Last I looked Monday, it was like at 45 and it was going down.
Let that shit keep dropping so I can buy some.
Right. you know, but the, and Bitcoin trades 7 days a week. Like you can do that 7 days a week. That shit just steady going down. When it finally does bottom out, it will be a good time to buy some stock for people who never did it before. But that's gonna be the good thing. The bad thing is they're not gonna have the money. They're not gonna have the capital to buy the damn stock.
Yep.
So the stupid shit that 45 probably has done more press conferences this week than in his entire term, every year of his term. You know, and he still hasn't sounded presidential not one time.
Nope.
Not one. The problems he has, no assurance, no definites, no fucking nothing, man. And the $1,000 or $2,000, whatever they kick out, they gonna figure out a way how to get that shit back.
Oh yeah.
Send a 1099 form in the mail.
Now they're just gonna take it back out your taxes, like when Obama did his stimulus.
So, what do you do? Do they put something out there for the big companies to make sure when they? I'm gonna say bailout because relief effort fund. I call it that. Remember when they did that shit in Obama's era administration, and the companies gave their CEOs bonuses, $1 million bonuses, right, and all of that shit. Don't let that shit happen again. Don't let that. They didn't get none of the shit to the people. I mean, the workers. You know,
well, that's
like,
what's gonna happen. If you get elected again, that's what's gonna happen. This shit's gonna pass over, and everything gonna go right back to business. You're gonna have people in the streets suffering, and you're gonna have all the CEOs making this money. You're gonna have these big companies, Amazon and all of them, still not paying no taxes.
Right.
We shouldn't even be where we at right now. If all these major companies were paying taxes, have half the deficit right now.
Nah, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. I heard Major League Baseball, each team donated $1 million for food. I believe it was for food, for people that need food. So they put $30 million up, you know. Other celebrities,
that's cool and all, but shit, where the food coming from? I just came from the grocery store right now, and it's looking thin out there.
It's a damned if you do, damned if you don't situation. You just buy a little bit at a time. I think what fucked up people was they went out and they bought as much as they could in one trip. Like, they would never go to the grocery store again. Now their kids waking up and these motherfuckers making lobster and cheese omelets and shit and scallops and shit for breakfast. You know what I'm saying? They eating outside of their beans. You know what I'm saying? Remember?
Right.
It was a shorty and it was just a cabinet full of canned goods. And he made a whole meal out of canned goods.
Bruh, we didn't even make grilled cheese sandwiches. We put a slice of cheese on a slice of bread and put that thing at the bottom of the oven. There you go.
Right.
What I'm saying.
You didn't get the second slice of bread.
Survival mode, bologna,
hot dogs and beans, dude. Hot dogs and pork and beans.
Hot dogs and beans, rice and peas. You know what I'm saying? A big ass bag of rice and peas. Straight up cereal. Like a canned goods. I ain't heard nobody say eat nothing popped out of canned goods. They straight feeding their kids gourmet meals. And here's another thing. The parents, I know both of you gentlemen are parents, but the parents, they 3 days in, they can't take it with the kids.
Right.
I like that.
And you know what they need to do? They need to wrap them up in all that tissue that they bought. I couldn't get tissue for shit. Hey,
literally. Joe Dirt couldn't get tissue for shit. Hey, my thing is, what's all the tissue for? What's all the toilet tissue for?
That's what I'm like. Supposedly a side effect of the diarrhea.
Who said that? I never seen that or read that.
Yeah, I saw that.
I ain't never read that.
But how much tissue you gonna need to wipe your ass with for diarrhea?
That's what I'm saying.
I'm saying worst case really scenario, you better do like the what they said that bidets, the people are buying those like crazy. They actually got stock going up right now. Because people having to rinse their ass. You better stick the booty hole over the tub.
You know what I'm saying?
Everybody get a 6-foot garden hose and hook it up to the sink.
Man, or something.
Basically.
I was just able to buy more water the other day.
Damn, I just bought all that out. I just been popping in the stores, grabbing a little bit at a time. If I go past the store, I just pop in and grab a little bit at a time. You know, I get water delivered. I get Hickley and Schmidt water delivered, cases of it delivered, and the 5-gallon jug that go on the machine. I get delivered to the house.
Damn, rich nigga.
I know what I've been doing. Every time I see one of them hand sanitizers, I reload my little mini bottles up. Every time I see one, I've been jacking everybody else. I'll be like, oh, you got this out? Okay,
I'll do the same shit.
Maybe look me like,
right.
Me like I'm crazy because they think I'm about to put my hand out instead. I put like a little bottle in there. They be like, real? I'm about to do that.
Like this the refill bottle. This the refill. You gotta refill my personal. Hell yeah, I do the same shit. Fucking the sports world. Who was the latest athlete that contracted the virus? Was it KD or was it somebody after KD?
Yeah, Durant and somebody in the NHL called it.
Dang.
I heard about that one. I know KD. Yeah. They ain't even said who the other four players or who the three players are with the Nets are that got it. They just said KD.
They said ain't none of them exhibiting symptoms. Only one of them is. So
yeah, all sports suspended. I could have sworn somebody on a baseball team tested positive.
I feel bad for the XFL, man. They was actually getting some attention, man.
They was actually playing decent, huh?
Yeah, it was. Absolutely. I was enjoying that shit too. I definitely was enjoying that shit.
Well, you know what? The one thing that I can say positive about this is if this shit prolonged, then, you know, I won't have to watch my sorry ass Bears with them sorry ass trades they've been doing and stuff right now.
That's the sports report. That's the sports report right there.
Sports report. The Bears gonna suck again.
I'm trying to tell you, D, you mad at me because I'm dogging your Bears, man.
To take the other side of it. Go ahead.
We gonna have a defense. That's again. But we ain't gonna have no offense.
To take the other side of that now. Optimistic. Nick Foles does know the offense. And his last win actually came against the Bears. Because before he got hurt at Jacksonville, he went 0-4 with them bums. But you see how bad that team was. But if you really think about it, man, if Jimmy Graham, when he went to Seattle and when he played for Green Bay, he didn't play the tight end position the way that he normally play it. They had him playing on a line. He not a line tight end. He a split out, and that's what they going to do with him. So all you can hope is that he able to get out there and do what he did with the Saints.
Go back to your first point. His last win against the Bears. Why did he win that game? He won that game because of the double doink, not because he was a damn.
No, he beat them again in the regular season too, didn't he?
I don't remember that one.
They played him again.
He went to Jacksonville. He was with Jacksonville last year.
Oh, right. No, I forgot they lost to what's his name because they played Philly again this year. But yeah, that was his last win. But shit, at least he know the offense. He gonna be the starting quarterback.
Well, that ain't hard.
Well, it's supposed to be a competition.
Once again, that ain't hard. I got ready to say Rex Grossman. Damn. Trubisky lost. He sat there and damn near lost his starting position to Chase Daniel. Come on.
Nah. But I mean, I guess, man, but at least you got somebody that know the offense and can read defenses and throw a damn accurate pass, at least.
What was they deal with not getting Cam?
But Cam, he ain't worked out for nobody. Don't nobody know if he's still hurt or not.
And Nick Foles was hurt last year, too.
You know what the deal is with not getting Cam or Bridgewater.
Right.
I don't care.
Bridgewater never was coming. Bridgewater was never coming.
Well, he came and talked to him.
No, they put that was what his agent was saying. He wanted to go to Tampa Bay, not Tampa Bay, but Carolina. But they gave him the bread.
Okay.
And that's a better, let's be honest, that's a better situation. You know what I'm saying?
I just don't like the way they did Cam.
No, I don't like the way they did Cam either.
You can hang it. The Bears, the top office, the front office or whatever, say, all right, this is how much money we willing to spend on a quarterback. Right? Go out and make this work. Here's the other thing you can't do. Can't be a black quarterback or a quarterback of color.
The only other option was Jameis, which I wouldn't have been mad if they would have picked up Jameis, you know, even if he was a backup or something.
If they would have got that. Now, on the flip side, the other option is, we'll get a black quarterback. We're not paying them all this money.
That's true, but you weren't able to get one.
They would have got for 25% of what he's worth, or 50% of what he's worth for a season or something like that. Just to say, hey, we got a top 10 quarterback for cheap.
I think they need to draft a quarterback.
I do that, so I believe that's what they're gonna do because Nick Foles ain't gonna be here that damn long.
Wait a minute, what? They just drafted fucking Trubisky.
That was what, 3-4 years ago.
Yeah, exactly.
He gone.
So what make you think they gonna get it right?
If it messes up, they gonna get fired. This ain't the Bulls. Not the Bulls. They'll keep them. The Bears, they gonna fire them. If this was the Bulls would be like, yeah, we give you some more time. Yeah, keep going. Keep trying.
They draft quarterbacks. They trade for a halfway washed up quarterback. You know that only played 3 quarters. But it's, you know, draft a quarterback. You know, they still don't get it right. The algorithm for them is not what other NFL teams are doing.
And right.
Somewhere down the line, it's going to movie about this dumb shit. It's going to be the only benefit. Like the Bears just holding on to 85.
I give Nagy the benefit of the doubt because he know what type of quarterback he need to run his system. And Ryan Pace, he just fucked up drafting. You know, the quarterback position. And shit. And he just got rid of, Leonard Floyd, who was another top pick. So, and he need to get his shit together with the damn drafting.
But if you want to make some money this year, D, Joe, bet against the Bears. Bet against the Bears. Just bet against them. If they add an extra week to the season in 17 weeks, Bears will not be 500.
They're going to win about 8 or 9 games. They're going to win 8 games because the defense will help them do that.
This is what I was just about to say this, Joe. Hey, they're going to against the top-rated team. Offense and defense. Defense can't do all of it. I'll just let you know. And the way that shit happens is that quicksand set in, and the defense gonna be like, we playing our asses off, and the offense ain't doing shit. And they gonna say, shit, why am I playing so hard and damn it get myself injured? I'm gonna save myself, and I'm gonna go to another team. That's just what, or they just gonna fucking retire. That's their algorithm. Like they will not make it. If it's 17 weeks in the season this year, they will be under 500. They will not make 500, and they're definitely not. They will be. I almost want to say they're gonna be last in the division, but I'm gonna say they're gonna be third.
No, they're not. They're gonna be second because the Vikings still can't figure them out, and they better than Detroit. I bet you your stimulus money that the Bears be 500 at least.
So we talking about 8-8, or we talking about 9-8?
Well, if it the 17-week season ain't this year though, it's next year, right?
I don't know.
It's not this season.
I think they was gonna shorten preseason to only 3 weeks.
No, I don't think that applies to this season yet.
I think they were talking about
this. It's not shortening the games. They're shortening the training. Training is going to be shortened down this preseason.
That's what I'm saying.
Now it's not for this season. Where it's going to be 17 weeks. That's next season. This season is still going to be 16 games or whatever. 17, however many weeks they play 16 games.
No, I could have swore they said they was going to cut down the preseason 4 weeks, correct?
Right, but that's not this season yet.
Okay.
Because they're still under the regular, what's the name? What do you call that thing? The regular collective bargaining agreement. Yeah, I think this is the last year for it. That's why they was trying to get it done.
Okay. I'll take you up on that bet. I'll take you up on a bet.
Right. We can go game money.
He said stimulus money. We could just go $100 a game for the whole season. You know, that's more than the stimulus money, as far as I'm concerned, because I'm on win.
Yeah, that's 17 weeks now, not 16, man. You talking, dang, man.
Hey, all they got to do is lose 10 games, and I win.
They're not going to lose 10 games.
Look here, man. All the teams got to do is put up 15, 17 points, and the Bears going to lose.
But you got to put them up first.
That's easy.
Against that defense?
That's easy.
Okay.
Wow. I'm with you, Joe. I say the Bears ain't gonna go 8-9 or nothing. I think if their quarterback play gets better, whatever, which I think is gonna probably get better because he's gonna have somebody on his ass, and if not, you know, when they put him in there, Nick Foles. Nick Foles step up at the end of the year. He's gonna get him into the playoffs probably. Because you gotta realize more playoff teams this year.
D, when you, Trey and myself was having dinner that night, what did I tell Trey? You remember when we was talking about Brady, right? And I told Trey, I said, dude is going someplace warm. But he's definitely leaving, he's going someplace warm. Now I said the Bay or I said Oakland. And Trey said, no, he's gonna stay in New England and get that bread. Brady signs with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, Florida. A warm state. My point to this is, if I tell you tomorrow's Easter start boiling eggs, they will not be a 500 team. I'm taking Joe for $100 a game.
So what you gonna do when you give me all that money? Now I don't want no check. I want a crisp $100.
Hey, I'm gonna give you $100 every time I see you. But meanwhile, you send my money through Cash App or Zelle. You send my money Cash App through Zelle. Every Monday, I take my money after the game. 5 minutes after the game, you can send my money over. Straight up, I'm done with the Bears, man. If I tell you tomorrow Easter, start boiling eggs, man. told you Brady was leaving. Told you he was leaving. Trey, I told you he was leaving. I think Trey owed me some money off of that shit.
Well, I kind of felt that Brady was leaving, too, because they didn't want to pay him. They didn't want to give him the contract. And they weren't going to give him the money he was looking for.
He tired of playing with some bums.
They wasn't gonna give him that contract. They wasn't giving him that money.
He wasn't building a team around him.
$40 million. That's true too, but they wasn't going to give him the money. Bill Belichick gets rid of motherfuckers. Y'all remember? He got rid of Richard Seymour. He gets rid of people before he feel like he can't use them no more. And that's exactly what he was gonna do.
Okay. Political news, sports, all of this shit. We just talking. The only good thing about sports is if they bring out that what's it called? The Michael Jordan 20. What the hell is it called? What's the correct
title?
One
last dance. 30 for 30. One last dance.
30. That's the Michael Jordan joint with everybody. Like, yeah. They need to bring that shit out, man.
They need to come on with it. They already released.
They got the Game Pass and they got NBA League Pass open for us to look at all these replays.
Yeah, they need to come on.
They trying.
Because it's supposed to drop in June.
Yeah, but if the NBA is saying they might start back up in June, July. you know, so that the, I can see that not playing well with the Jordan thing. The Jordan thing was going to probably come on like the weekend or the week after the finals was over with. I don't know what the exact date is, but I'm guessing it'd probably be like Father's Day
weekend. I think they was going. It was supposed to be the beginning of June. They were supposed to run it during the finals.
Okay, makes sense.
They probably like the time. Days off. Yeah, like in between the time that they not playing.
So now,
because it's now I think it's like six episodes of that shit or something.
I mean, six rings. I'm pretty sure they said they fought. Cameras from each championship season.
Yeah, that's gonna be good.
Hey, that's gonna be hella good, man. That shit gonna be hella fucking good.
So, and Muggsy Bogues said Mike killed his confidence when he was playing him one day. He called him a midget bitch. He said he couldn't play the same no more.
Oh, that was on the trailer?
No. I forgot what I was watching. I don't think he said it. Somebody was telling the story because he played with Muggsy. And Muggsy Bogues told him that story. He said, man, it might kill my confidence.
Damn.
Told him, shoot the ball, you little midget bitch.
I believe it.
Was this before or after Space Jams?
Damn. He probably put him in Space Jam to make up for that.
Come on, you little midget bitch. I'll make you a movie star. Ain't that some shit? But speaking of June, July, like if the season starts back up in June, July, right? Does KD come back and play?
Nope.
No.
It'll be a year. It'll be a year, right? It'll be a year since he went down, right?
Actually, yeah, he probably will come back because he was going to come back for the Olympics. Remember, he was talking about coming back for the Olympics, and he was pissed about that. So you might have something that he might be trying to come back for that. You know, first you need to get over Corona first. So, you know, we'll see.
Yeah, and then does Brooklyn potentially come out of the East?
If he go back and play right now, no, nah, ain't.
What's their record right now?
If they start the season, if they pick the season back up in June, July, and you got a healthy KD, can Brooklyn go on a winning streak or make it be in the playoffs and come out of the East?
No, because Kyrie hurt. He ain't playing the rest of the year.
You talking about the regular rest of the basketball season? But if the season not gonna start back up until June or July, Kyrie will be playing.
No, he not. He done like come until on. Next season.
Okay. I didn't know that part. So you're saying that he's done. Okay. But KD can't carry him, Joe. That's what you're saying?
No.
I bet you $100 a game, Joe.
They not beat Milwaukee. Just KD alone, they beat Milwaukee.
I bet you $100 a game. I'm gonna get all this money. That was some good shit. A lot of sports, no fucking boxing, and you know, Wilder signed on for another.
Man, I think that's gonna be a whole nother episode. We might have to keep this going right now because I just wanted to hear like the ending of stimulus package money being lost. We gonna do it. So what did you do with your stimulus money seminar? It's gonna be like, oh well, I couldn't get no Purell and I couldn't get no toilet paper, so I decided to bet on the Chicago Bears.
Right.
Yeah. that would be Joe betting on them. I'm betting against them. I'm betting on any team that's playing against
them. And I'm taking my stimulus money and I'm going to buy them Dior Jordans and I'm gonna take them and sell them.
That's Joe, a cool question right there, D. Well, so
I'm about to tell you this right now. If Joe decides to take his little money, his little funky $1,000 and spend it on Jordans, we definitely gonna get Ugo of the Week to come back.
I'm going to battle Jordan
out of summer.
Hey, them joints $2,000. I'm going to buy them, but I'm going to sell them.
Jackass of the summer, you go out and buy some things.
Joe going to be claiming everybody, kids, like it's tax season for real.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, what? Yeah. That's the question right there, D. What you plan on doing? What you plan on doing?
With your stimulus package money? Hold on, how about we ask the man to just log into the cave for the first time?
Yeah. Trey, what up? Can you hear us, Trey?
Man, he got cat goddamn internet. Right.
He's stealing his neighbor internet.
Oh. There you go. Hey. They got a big ass lip. God damn.
Hey, you still your neighbor internet?
Huh?
You still your neighbor internet?
Nah, nigga, this my internet, motherfucker. Wish I could steal somebody.
This the internet your lady paid for?
Nah, I pay for this shit, nigga. Fuck out.
The question we posing is, what you gonna do with your little stimulus money that you about to get from your elected president?
Actually, you assholes, for the people that's out, people that ain't working, you know what I'm saying? Them the people that's getting it. Since my industry is on the approved list of essential personnel type bullshit, because I'm a skilled laborer, I don't get the shit.
Oh, sucks to be you.
Exactly. What the fuck is $1,000 for me? The fuck is that?
Hey, I didn't even see the list, but I better get my money. Like, I work for a municipality.
Hold on. Y'all are killing me right now. Hold on. You got Drake trying to sound intelligent, and then you got Sly saying words that he can't spell. There's too much going on. Look, who said a municipality?
I work for multiple personalities.
I'm going to get you too. But I'm going to tell y'all what, though. I already have been known to my job. They ain't met Nigga Trey yet. See, they know. Fuck with my money, they gonna meet Nigga Trey. Now, but this thing, I can't remember what the name of it is. It's something called Not at Will, some shit. They shut my shit down. My job say don't go no more. Nigga, I'm going to get unemployment on this. I ain't using a vacation day. Y'all better put my debt. I earned them vacation days. It ain't my fault you motherfuckers the world falling apart. Fuck that.
Come on, Trey, you can come deliver some packages, man. Come work for me.
Nigga, like, y'all be complaining. Y'all forget. I go immediately.
Hey, you say that, but.
Like, for real, yo. I'm not bullshitting y'all. Like, yo, one motherfucker won't be coming to their house. He say, put a mask on. I can't put on a fiberglass mask. I'm allergic to that shit. That shit take my skin off. The motherfuckers are like, we had an impasse. I was like, nah, really, y'all can reschedule you. He was like, so how? When are we coming? Tomorrow? I was like, no, see, it's going to be 14 days out. Because now you gonna be on the quarantine list because you want us to do some shit we ain't comfortable with. So yeah, this shit all crazy, bro.
Hey, Joe just said that Trey gonna be delivering packages. Hey Trey, tell him you've been delivering packages since '96.
Different cans, different states. We got not always been delivering some kind of package. Yeah. I got all these gadgets.
Trey using his stimulus package money for a Vegas trip.
You know what that is? You know what money I'm using? That's my lift. Look, that's my lease. My lift money. I'll be throwing that shit on the side. Yeah. My lift.
Welcome rolling to the.
What's up?
What's going on, bro?
Man, sorry I'm late.
Hey, it's cool. We raw and unfiltered up in here, you know. We talking about whatever's clever, raw, from politics to sports, the coronavirus. We talking about everything.
It's
raw. So we need some of that tinfoil hat conspiracy theory, bro.
You know I got it.
Hey, Ro, is it wrong when I get my stimulus money, I'm going to buy Jordans?
Yeah, that's 100% wrong. 100% wrong. But, you missed the whole point.
Hey,
what
Joe,
if we get him from,
what I'm gonna do if I
get him from the what if Joe gets from the Robin Hood of sneaker goods? Is it still wrong?
It's 100% wrong. You're supposed to be buying food and soap and medicine and toilet paper.
I got all that already.
I got all. If you've been a normal human being, you got all that shit anyway, cuz.
Right. Like, he's a normal.
It's like normal humans wash their ass. They wipe they wash their hands. They wipe their ass, hopefully, not in that order. You know what I'm saying? But if you've been a normal person, you ain't worried about that shit. I say we go old school. We take this shit back to like 98. We put all our checks together. We get us two little dope boys and we just run the streets, cuz.
And that was the other option.
Outside, Jack.
Now, look, now that's something. That's something I can stand behind.
Hell yeah, we could carter this bitch out somewhere. They ain't got projects no more, but we get one of these. Hey, I'm telling you, man, we'll pass something, cuz. And do it, cuz, for real. We ain't got shit to worry about. Fuck it. We all got our niches. We all can goddamn it be hood. This nigga got me watching Blues Clues.
All white bricks.
Hey, Trey. Trey.
What's happening?
You remember when we went out to dinner and we had the conversation about Brady and I told you the man was gonna leave New England and go someplace warm?
Yeah.
You owe me $100 then, nigga. You owe me $100, nigga. You owe me $100.
Hey, explain. Slide. Explain this. What? I must not have been up on it, but what happened? Why did he so all of a sudden leave? What happened?
Man, look. Me and Ro probably the oldest one on here right now, right? And we in our 40s. Y'all not knocking on y'all 40, right? I know.
Shit, I'll be 40 this year.
I know the man
wanted to go someplace warm. He got a hot wife, his kids coming up. You don't want them growing up in cold ass Connecticut while you you know what I'm saying? You like, yo, it's time for me to bail out. He was due $40 million. You know, so he like, if I can't get 40, I'm at least about to play in some 75 degree weather every Sunday. Well, at night, you know, so that was a no-brainer. No.
He could have been there, that.
The only reason he didn't go through.
Not for $40 million.
Is because he can't follow Peyton. Damn. Hey, mijo. Oh, yeah, poo. I see. Oh, you must want me to stay. Go get me a pound.
Yeah, now, I told y'all this the podcast raw. Man. This is the podcast raw.
Yeah, that's Corona. Ain't no child care. Ain't no nothing.
Yeah, this is definitely social distancing.
You don't want to be involved, man.
Trey. On this podcast, we promise to edit things, but we never do. So put your thing on mute.
Oh, cuz, it's cool. Don't worry about it. I ain't going to...
Now, we talking about... We don't know if all the followers want to hear about you changing diapers.
It's nigga Trey.
I got him muted.
Wait. Hold on a second. After all this time, this is the infamous Trey? Wait a minute. Slow down. Pump the brakes.
Yeah, let me tell you motherfucker something. I ain't no fucking crackhead. Yes, this is
Trey.
The fuck out of here, crack it.
That's your boy CB.
I know, I hear his big titty ass.
Fucking ass Trey.
Shut your ass up, nigga.
That's the CB. It's me. This spot.
CB ass finna get a check. He finna get two checks, one for each titty. His fat ass. Nigga, need to get you a steel tray. Damn, robots your job and shit. How you sit down here and you ain't bring your wife? Look what I'm supposed to do. Wife, bro. Just don't. I fucked that one up. I didn't know this nigga gave you wife. Only cuz he be like, nigga, he let me know. He bring me wipes, he bring me a pamper, we get it cracking, he go about his day. Everybody fucking happy. He ain't no
hey, that's raw, unfiltered daddy life. While you social distancing and schools are closed.
Nigga, I ain't got no choice. Ain't no social distancing in this motherfucker. Like that shit ain't possible. Hell, hey,
Did you wake up and cook the kid a lobster and cheese omelet?
No, I ain't do nothing like that. I went, nigga. I don't have a choice right now. My job, they already let me know.
know. These niggas is up and running until further notice. Until Uncle Sam say everybody stay their ass home. Nigga, I gotta go to work, nigga. I'm booked completely because I got like, I'm working like between 8 and 10 calls a day.
It's damn.
Amazing, man. But it ain't no traffic. Y'all ever seen 28 days?
Yeah, it ain't no traffic out there, Jack.
It is, for real.
None.
Yeah.
Man, ain't no. Don't move, dude. Stay right there. Don't like walk around and piss in a plane. You know when they little
daddy like, daddy like, bro, what's going on? Look, what's going on? What you do?
My joint bro. Up here, man. We still good for a minute. Non-essential shut down. I own a hair salon, so we had to shut down. But gas stations, grocery stores. I just came from the gun shop about a half an hour ago. That's still open.
That's the most important place right there.
The gas station or the gun shop?
The gun shop.
I agree.
They ran out of bullets in Illinois.
They ran out of bullets.
Mm-hmm. You can't buy bullets. That shit gone. Can't find no damn toilet tissue. Can't find no damn
bullets. Go on 79th and Western or Inglewood, you can get all kind of bullets.
Yeah, you probably have to pull, you have to pull them bullets out of somebody.
You can just get off the 290 on Independence. They sell everything right on the ground, Joe. You gotta go to the store.
You sure they out of bullets or they out of the bullets that you need? That's different.
Nah, them motherfuckers, like, they had to shut a lot of stores down because they ain't got shit else in there.
Wow, they just sold everything up.
Yeah, because you know you can't pull the delivery truck up while people in there shopping. So they had to tell people we was out of bullets, you know what I'm saying? Like, cause they can't have that delivery and people there for business at the same time. Motherfucker take the whole truck.
So what you gonna do with your stimulus package, bro?
I got a Sky. What's this motherfucker called? The Sky CPX2, and I already had a Taurus G2C. And I just got this little. It's still a 9mm. I copped it for the wifey to have when I'm gone. You know, something at the crib. So I just wanted to make sure I had two. I mean, I ain't like other people when it came. They got the little, you know, the lock and all that, you know what I mean? With the armor and, you know, the 50 cal. And I ain't got all that yet, but I'm getting there.
Yeah, we got people with machine guns.
Yeah. See people in the cave, man. They ain't playing around. I ain't that level.
Got like, tripod and shit, yeah.
Hey, bro, why don't you M60? Name them people? Why don't you call them out?
Huh?
Why don't you call them people out? Them people who got mental issues with when it comes to guns and stuff like that.
I ain't trying to put that man business in the street.
Oh man, if anybody been listening to Inside the Cave before it got shut down, they know who the hell you talking about.
Oh, cousin Lamar.
No, damn man, you just dimed out. I was playing, bro.
See, look, you see how
Negroes
do? It sets you up to snitch.
Then, hey, we gotta have a CB on the show today, so you him.
Yeah, where he at anyway? He didn't really left us alone, huh?
He was out. He out somewhere, man.
He outside. He picking right now.
He's still at work, mad that he had to build them cars.
Hey, look, I still gotta build them trains.
Right. Yeah.
We ain't closing either, man.
They
not playing. They said, bring your ass to work.
That's how I sound like FedEx.
Yeah, y'all better be delivering. I need y'all. Well, no, that's not true. My packages come in UPS. That ain't
right. Yeah, see?
Competitive.
Man, I heard Amazon hiring 100,000 people.
Yeah, I seen just, that.
And
I don't get that. You know what? In the UK, they shutting down. All they delivering is medical supplies.
Yeah, wow. That's what they doing through Amazon. You can't sell nothing. I don't think they only delivering medical supplies, but as far as reselling go, you can't resell shit but medical supplies.
And they
AD.
You can buy groceries through Amazon too.
I am in the States.
Oh, okay. That's what I thought. How long you here for? You here for the duration?
Bruh, I don't know right now. I have no idea. Based on the way things going, you missed the beginning of the damn show. It ain't no international deal. It ain't no stateside. Don't know where I want to be. So,
I hear that, bro.
Everything is messed up all over the world. Germany is messed up. The UK, everything is messed up. So, you know what, Ro? You know what you be doing, Ro?
What?
You be like Sly when he be putting them memes in the group and they be like 30 years late. You be coming up to the situation 20 years late. News been out there for 30 years and you come back, oh yeah.
No, it's not, they be on East Coast time. Like I just be catching up, man. I don't mind. It just let me know y'all pay attention to the shit that I drop up in there, even if it is late. So I feel like I'm right on time.
Sly had your back. I said Sly working like a runaway slave. I said he ain't got time to be in the group.
Did you shit? You see what I pulled up at all, dude? Man, to get
that.
Yeah,
I know that was.
I pulled right up to the front door.
Like, what is you doing, bro? You can't pull the door into the loader.
The fuck, I can't. I couldn't park that shit in the regular parking spot.
You should have drove in there and got all the tissue.
I would have got my paper towels, some soup, you know, some survival shit. You know what I'm saying? Some canned goods.
Okay, answer me this. Why is everybody buying toilet paper?
That's what I asked.
That's what I asked too, bro. That's the same thing. Now, who was?
Well, somebody help me out.
D said it's a side effect. A side effect is
diarrhea.
It ain't no damn diary, you crazy.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody go, you know what I'm saying, at a different pace. You know what I mean? Period. You know, I don't understand this.
Why did I unmute this nigga?
Do all this bullshit. Hey, nigga, you muted me? What kind of bullshit is that?
Nah, you unmuted. You ain't muted. You mute. Nah. Everybody go at a different pace. That sound real scientific, Trey.
Nah, what I mean by that whole diarrhea shit, who the fuck, everybody don't get, like, basically you get the scaredy shits. That's why people buying all this tissue. That's where we talking about. That's the reason. It's the scaredy shits. The bubble gut.
No, that ain't that.
That ain't the reason either.
Since I work in that industry, let me. This is what I think. I think it's because it's during the times of like 9 to 5 or 7 to 6 when the house is normally empty. Now you have a house full of people. You know, more than usual at these times of day, and they're going to consume and use up more food, more product, more water, more tissue. They're going to use the washroom a lot more. And on my side of the industry, some of these children and or adults, they're taking the disinfectant wipes, paper towel, and they're actually flushing the shit down the toilet, right? So they call us out to actually ride out the sewer drain, so because the shit ain't getting all the way out to the street, right? Now, take heed to this, people. Only put toilet tissue down. That's the only thing that breaks down. Not a disinfectant wipe, not a wipe that say it breaks down, not a paper towel, not a napkin. Anything other than toilet tissue will fuck your shit up. And then you call a person out like me after I get off my regular job and I get to charge you hundreds of dollars to do some shit that's really simple for you not to fuck up. So that's
hey,
my...
Man.
What's up?
But some people ain't got no choice because, you know, when them boys at the door and you trying to flush some shit down the drain because, you know, you can't get that case. I still call you and have you ride my
Trey, Trey, you know, so what, so when you heard them say, "Hey, everybody work from home," everybody that can work from home needs to work from home. You said that shit wasn't working for you in the '90s. You did that shit and you got raided, huh?
I'm gonna tell you.
It wasn't working from home. That's part of the commandment. That's part of the commandment. You don't let these motherfuckers know where you lay your, you fucking rest your head at. That's like the first no no. Hell no.
I'm gonna tell you this though. Peep this. If they kicking the door, bro, flushing it down the toilet is not gonna work. They already got all the evidence they need. All that is just dope on the table. That's it. If the feds kick the door, that's a 2-year investigation. They got you on lock. I know from experience.
That means somebody snitched.
Yeah, absolutely.
Look, that means somebody snitched, and we already seen who a snitch already. You know what I'm saying? Because we already seen that shit. Not to fuck with if you in that line of work. You know what I'm saying?
CB is not here to defend himself. Leave CB out of it. CB is not here to defend himself about being a snitch that he always tell it when he never asked the question.
Look, I'm going to tell you something. CB done gave negative 47 fucks about somebody not being there to defend themselves, right? Nigga, I was on one show, right? At the fucking hell place. You know what I'm saying? I was on one show, right? Hey, it was cool. I only had one chance to defend myself. This nigga put it in the intro for a while. Like, what the fuck? I'm gonna let my chick listen to some. These your guys? Yeah. But look, well, why they say this? Like, you don't know what I used to do.
Yeah, these your guys.
The nigga said he put it in the intro and shit.
Like, what the fuck? Like, I'm so bold, like, no, cuz that's not, no. And he got half the cave believing that. I think half the cave actually believed I was hooked on some kind of fucking hard drug.
Well, I missed that episode, like, Trey, but I'm willing to put my mind down now. I bet you $100 that the nigga was wrong.
Look, I'm gonna let y'all know. It's just like that saying, the hair fake. Like the way CB tell it, CB is motherfucking Bob Saget. That's the nigga that's like, you here for weed? Nigga, I suck dick for coke. That's CB.
Whoa.
That's why you put that on.
Pause. What the fuck that just was said?
That's gonna be the next one week's intro.
Hold on.
No. We gonna mute Trey for a little bit.
Go back on the no editing. I'm gonna need you to edit that because whatever he got in his weed is laced or something, because he did not just say that.
No, nigga.
He got that Rona in his shit.
Look, man. He got the Corona in there?
Trey, you're talking about something. I got these cheeseburgers, dog. I got these cheeseburgers.
Nah, cuz. It ain't like that. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, Trey, that was funny shit. That was some fucking funny shit, man. About this traveling shit.
I mean,
price is dirt cheap. Price is dirt cheap. Anybody got any trips booked?
Look, everybody need to come, man. What the fuck?
Dude, if you getting in a
who
plane...
Who all on our flight? On the flight with me?
If you trying to get in a plane, huh? You crazy.
Why?
Dude, I recirculated after.
Dude, I ain't worried. Look, nigga. I go in these motherfucking houses. Nigga, I ain't worried about this bullshit. The only thing I'm actually worried about, and I'm gonna be brutally fucking honest, is I do like get some shit or like, cause it's like I'm not in the age range. I don't have like you know what I'm saying, like major respiratory health problems. I'm not in none of the categories that I actually gotta worry about. Like this shit is like being blown out of proportion to an unseen fucking degree, because it's not like you catch it, you die, and you come back to life for no bullshit. Like, get the fuck out of here, cuz. More people still die from one.
So you,
like,
you
y'all do realize this shit.
You probably will have a harder time smelling like breathing regular air, like real good air. You probably will have a fit with that shit because you so used to breathing bullshit.
I'm just wondering what about that six. I'm trying to figure out what about that 60-year-old side piece you got, that sugar mama. She gonna get sick.
I ain't got my chick not 60 because I ain't got no sugar mama. I work for mine, so.
Well, 59. 59.
Tell you, I got me one younger than me, cause she about her shit. That's what it is. You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up.
Yeah, I was old. I used to like the older women cause they take care of you. I ain't wanna fuck with no young chick. But yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's cause they get pay on they she'll go get it just like me. You know what I'm saying? So it's like fuck it. But you know what I'm saying? I regress. Real talk, all this fucking is being, man, what I mean by being blown out of proportion. Some of the other fucking sicknesses before this, the swine flu, the all this, more people died from that shit, cumulative, than what's the word I want to say? Than this shit. Y'all do like realize that, right? Like this is not the end of the world, and that's what everybody making it out to be, and it's not. Like it's so fucking not. You're 60 or older, if you ain't got,
well, I mean, you got. You definitely got a point. Then explain this then.
When, like the only one I'm saying about, is I'm looking for my CEO.
Why are they shutting shit down then? Explain that.
You know what it is? Because think about it, because they don't do that is exactly. I was just about to say. Because if they still let people out doing what the fuck they do, eventually, motherfuckers, y'all forget, it's still carry in a lot of states. Motherfuckers is gonna lose their fucking mind, somebody make a mistake and fucking sneeze on them, a cough in their fucking direction, bro. Motherfuckers gonna start shooting people for that shit. So it's either shut shit down and keep people cool, or let the bullshit happen and we fuck around and go into martial law. Because that's the next fucking step after that.
I read a meme that was pretty interesting, and we know we don't believe memes around here, but it was spitting some factual shit. It was like, we had SARS, we had swine flu, we had Zika, all in the Obama administration, and we didn't shut shit down. Shit was still moving. So I'm like, what's the difference? And you know me, I ain't even know, I don't even be capable of Obama like that.
Look, the difference is this, cuz this shit that they doing, everybody forget what was happening before this fucking virus or whatever was out. Hong Kong was protesting, cuz.
Right.
Them niggas have been known since the back in the day to fucking fuck their own people up. You talking to a weapons troop. You get what I'm saying? I used to be in the military, right? You know what I'm saying? That was my job. I did fucking explosives and weapons and shit for the Jets. So it's like different shit. Like I really got into that shit. China was one of those fucking countries, and this is common knowledge. If everybody know, you want to fucking scare a black man, keep his ass, keep whatever you want in the book. You'll scare his ass, right. You won't find it. Mm-hmm. Fuck that. Black man, I like. You got niggas to read. I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? And that was one of the things I found interesting. China always done fuck their own people up and test the shit on their own people. Nigga, this, y'all don't find it. China would kill their old, China would kill their females. Like, think about this shit, huh? This shit got out of hand. Because the world's so interconnected. That's all it really is. If you really want to think about it, it wouldn't surprise me if y'all want to talk about the whole conspiracy shit and the Illuminati and all that shit. If it's some some sustenance behind that shit. Every major continent is getting touched with this shit, bro. It's just thin in the fucking herd. Look at who is affected. Old, really old, and really young. All the able-bodied motherfuckers gonna be okay. Cause then we gotta put the shit back together.
Okay.
Hey, you gotta get some of the mugs out of here.
So, hey, check this out, y'all.
That's what I'm saying.
I wanna ask each one of y'all this question. Again, in 2 weeks, 2 weeks from now, 2 weeks from today, I don't know what the date is. It'll be April, I guess. What is it, the 18th? Yeah, it'll be like April something, right? In two weeks, what would you had wish you had done?
Buy some stock.
That's it.
Yep. Everything else I did. I need some of them.
Joey,
shots,
what about you?
In 2 weeks.
What do I wish I would have done?
Yeah. Yeah.
Probably bought a brick of cocaine instead of them Jordans with that stimulus money.
Yay, yo. Yay, yo. Yay, yo. Hey, yo, Trey. Yo, Trey. In 2 weeks, what would you have wish you had done? Yeah, in two weeks from now, and you look back on these 2 weeks, what would you have wish you had done in that 2 week of time?
You get want time? Make sure I get right there, ass on OT. Get my motherfucking checkup. Fuck out of here. I better eat this shit up, nigga. Fuck y'all. God damn it. Y'all wanna shut? Nigga, look, between that and left, nigga, I'm trying to make money, man. Fuck all this bullshit. The only thing in 2 weeks I wanna look back on to say is I ain't changed shit and my family still ate. That's like my main fucking thing, cuz. I mean,
D, what about
not
you?
Not serious, like.
So, both of my statements are going to be road related. Number one, I agree. I wish I would have brought certain stocks earlier in the week. I'm going to get something. I'm out and got something now. So, stock is one thing. And number two, pre-brief row on motherfuckers' relationship status before he go putting shit on blast and being tricked down. Hey, put shit out there that ain't. I'm gonna need you. I'm gonna need to bring you to the 2020, bro.
My bad.
That's a kill. A kill yourself and start over.
It is. Damn, my bro. Dad in a minute. Damn.
And what would I wish I had done in 2 weeks? 2 weeks from now, I would hope that I have created some type of power shift, like switched over to doing something, maybe learning a new trade, particularly, or getting a new hustle, or in the 2 weeks time, maybe learn something new that I could utilize somewhere else. That's just being real. Like the stock stuff, I get that. I'm with you. Joe, we're gonna go half on that too. Like we can go four and a baby, we can get a split too and all that shit. Like I got some on it too with my stimulus package money. But in 2 weeks I wish I had did something.
Hey to, look, I know a couple of niggas that we can put that shit out on too, cuz deep areas, dog. Let me know.
Did this nigga just admit to a felony on radio?
Hey man, shit.
All
shit,
I said is I know a couple niggas
that do that. In two weeks, the shit might be legal, bro.
Right. That might be legal. You ain't lying.
In two weeks, the shit might be legal, bro.
I'm gonna let y'all know. Y'all gotta be like he's saying. Y'all gotta be a jack off of trades, man. You know what I'm saying? Y'all talk, like, DB used to talk a lot of shit about me, but guess what? We got a CNA license. We got a phlebotomy license. I can go medical, cuz. Y'all got to do a couple of things to make sure y'all still eating, man. Real. Like I feel you on that, bro. Cuz if you don't, man, some of these businesses finna dry the fuck up, yo. Like, legitly. If this can last as long as this shut down supposed to. Man, they talking about different fucking airports, airlines. About to have to file banking.
Well, how can people save money? Since you bring up the bill, how can people save money? I'll tell you a way people can save money. Since ain't nobody going to work and ain't nobody got to go to school, you don't need no alarm clock. So unplug all of that shit. You don't need no fucking lights. The sun gonna be out in the morning. Unplug that shit. Unplug your fucking alarm clock. unplug any non-essential electricity that your ass don't fucking need.
Oh, slide.
And if you go into the fucking washroom, right? If you go into the washroom, and all you got to do is
keep pissing
until it gets to the morning.
You ain't got no keys in your house. Fuck that. Nigga, look, you ain't got no kids in your house. You never get no power.
Flush
go
the, out for the toilet three gets hours. Flushed once every 2 hours, nigga. Flush the toilet every once every 2 hours. Unless you shit, and then you flush it. Of course.
Nigga, I got what a question for you.
Once every 18 to 19 hours? What the hell?
Like you still use an alarm clock?
I'm saying, if anybody got any non-essential electricity.
But you ain't got my question. You still using an alarm clock?
No, I don't have. You know what I do, but it's not. It don't get plugged in the wall though.
You got a fucking roof. Change
the light bulbs to LED. Change the light bulbs to LED light bulbs. Save you some money on your car.
Oh man.
Oh, you said it. We said it earlier.
I tell them to wait.
He finna have y'all do all.
Ask them to wave your phone.
He finna have y'all do all this bullshit, right?
And don't use toilet paper. Don't use toilet paper. Just rinse your ass off with some water, right?
Right, like a boot. Old school and shit. Like, you know what, man? Fuck that, man.
Don't act like they got the water that spray up on your butt. They got those.
Bidet?
Yeah, that's what they say. They selling a lot of those.
Yeah. Nigga, that's some magical shit. If you ain't got a dead one, nigga, oh my God, nigga. This like the cleanest ass felt after taking this shit.
Hey, gentlemen, y'all want to help somebody tonight? I got a cast corner.
Got a problem? Need some advice? Send your questions and problems to Cat for Cat's Corner on Inside the Cave.
Okay, that's awesome.
It's actually two.
You knew Rell was going to say Captain Saber, bro.
I'm trying to save some hoes tonight. Let's go.
All right.
Don't say any bitches. Put them on the belt. Don't say no hoes. We let them bitches drown and land. And then we go get other people so they can point there. You know what I'm saying? We don't save nobody. I'll be good. Like I'll be good. I actually be positive. Alright, you know what I'm saying? I don't want nobody thinking I'm like some fucking ass.
We don't think that all the time, just 95% of the time. Alright, hold on. I mean
I wanna tell y'all something.
This is a cast corner right here. This is the first one. This is from Anonymous. Thank you for giving us that original name. We have been divorced for years, and he still posts long messages on Facebook about me whenever our former anniversary date appears, or birthdays, Valentine's Day, etc. We have nothing to do with each other, but he still does this. He claims he does this to show our children that he still loves me, but this is to show our children that he claims it is to show our children that he still loves me, but it's putting a strain on my new relationship every time he does it. Why do you think he keeps doing this and acting like we are an item when we are together? And he did none of this, by the way. The question is, fellas, why do you think he keeps doing this and acting like we are an item? Trey? Since you the new kid on the block, what's the answer? What's your answer?
Why do he keep acting like an item? He still want to fuck with her. He ain't over her. Man, dude, like, it's really what it is. He ain't over her. He ain't done fucking with her. So he doing whatever he can. Like, he on some whole shit. Sorry. I mean, you know, if I was her, you know, either you let your man confront him if you happy, or, you know, you confront him. I mean, I don't know if he said, hey, I don't want to do that no more, but he's doing it. Okay, to answer her question, he's doing it because he still wants to fuck with her. That's it. That's all.
Okay. All right. Joey?
He trying to get them booty draws. That's what he's trying to do.
Shit.
She must have some good stuff, boys. He tried to hit that again. He tried to get that special occasion.
You can't say it's good. I think he's
fucking jealous. I actually think he's fucking jealous. Like he doesn't have her no more. So the only thing that he can do is hold on to these dates. You know. You know what I'm saying? He's not doing anything with her, and all he has is these dates to make them pop. And they're probably meaningless to her, and he's trying to make them meaningful to her, and they don't mean a damn thing because the dates that she's celebrating are the dates of her new relationship. You know, that anniversary and her guy's birthday and shit like that. I'm going against what Trey said. I don't think he needs to say a motherfucking thing to do, or she needs to say anything to him. Baby girl, keep doing what you're doing. Because you gonna stay on his mind no matter what it is. It's up to him to forget you. You know what I'm saying? Because you already done forgot him. So you can't worry about him. You can't look backwards and forwards at the same fucking time. It's impossible. Shit. And that's she my forgot answer. Him. And this is sly.
She ain't forgot him. That's why she liked that shit. That's why she brought it up. She liked that shit. Women like that stuff.
That's what I'm gonna ask. Why is she still stuck on it? Why is it affecting her?
Well, she ain't say she's kind of feeling he never did. She gonna fuck with him again, or she's
I'm not saying that. It's like what I'm asking you is this: just think about it in this instance. She noticing it. The best thing to do: block him from all service.
Nigga, you notice your birthday every fucking year. You notice your fucking birthday every fucking year.
No, with this, hey, slide. Slide, what D's trying to say is that why in the hell she even see it? How is they even still social media friends?
I guess it probably got mutual friends. Man, like with all our letters that get sent like, in, it seemed like something be missing out of them.
Man, bro, she like that shit. And the only reason why it's still going on is because he knows she like that shit. He don't want her ass. He just want her ass to think he want her ass. Because if she dropped that nigga and go back, he gonna go right back to being who he was when he was with her. And the game changed. And she a fool for allowing that to disturb her relationship and her new dude, weak as hell, for even being with you and you going through that mess. He should have dropped you like a bad habit because apparently you ain't moved on because you still allowing that.
Preach.
At the end of the day, she need to stop being social media with the friends with the dude. You can co-parent your kids, no matter how old they are, via text message. If your kids is over 7, it's called here, your daddy on the phone. You ain't never gonna talk to that nigga. Come on now. That's some bullshit. She like it. So don't be calling into the cave trying to get some sympathy and trying to put it on him. Because he only doing what you allow him to do. And I love saving hoes, but this hoe I ain't saving.
Okay. All right. Well, there's your answer, Anonymous. There's your answer. You full
Ro
of shit.
Ro has spoken.
You full of shit, Anonymous. You just Ro is known for saving hoes, but not this time, Anonymous. He's not saving your ass. So I gotta commend Ro on this one because he stepped outside of his comfort zone and he said he called you out on your shit. Hey, you either gonna fuck him, suck him, or leave him the fuck alone. Now which one is it gonna be? That's from inside the cave.
She's looking for a reason to go back.
There you go. She, and you never know. She might be out somewhere and get drunk in a couple weeks, 4 weeks after the little shutdown is over with. And she might stumble and fall on his dick or something. Who knows? Right?
What you think she gonna wish she hadn't done 2 weeks ago?
So, you know, so, there you go, Anonymous. I hope you receive this information well. It's coming from four very respectful guys, and these are pretty nice guys, by the way.
Hey, look, he even said no, but he just said he agreed too. You agree?
You agree? Okay, you it's coming for four gentlemen and a baby. And we got another cast. we got another cast corner. I just sent it to you for you to read, man. So would you mind reading this one?
All right, hold on, let me get there. Damn, it's long as shit. y'all just want to clown me. All right, the heading is, can't find a job, suggest my wife get a job. Hector, listening to Inside the Cave podcast, and you all seem to be successful outside the podcast as well. You broke down your salary to after a divorce and child support to $9 an hour, and you said you couldn't do it. Well, here is my situation. I have been struggling to keep working. I work two part-time jobs at times to make ends meet. They're mostly temp jobs that come to an end after 6 or 7 months. Then I start the process over again. My wife hasn't worked since we started having children. We agree that it's more important for her to be home, but with our kids older now and me struggling to find consistent work, I suggest that maybe I stay at home and she try to find work, and maybe we will have better results than me. She will have better results than me. She was insulted by that idea. I think she is comfortable being at home all day. Meanwhile, I'm struggling working odd hours and just trying to find work. There has to be another way or an easier way. And all I did was suggest she trying to find work and see if we can get better results. She isn't interested in getting back into the work feel and is upset that I made that suggestion. How do I get my wife back to work and back to work, and any suggestions to me to find consistent work too? I'm a listener outside of Alexandria, Virginia. Anonymous.
That was it. That was the okay. Beginning of the next one. But okay. That was it. Thanks, bro. Hector, man, I don't want to go first on this one. Joe, Hector, Joe Dirt, ladies and gentlemen, Joe Dirt.
Hold on. Before you go, Joe, I want to say this, bro. Thank you for the transparency, man. That was hard to read, bro. Real talk. That was hard to read.
Hector, I'm assuming by your name that you're Hispanic. Now, we all on this show know Hispanics like to work. So when you say that your wife don't want to work, come on, Hector, I don't believe that. You got your white girl or a sister, Hector? Come on, you got your sister, she know how to get it. She know how to get over on the system. She got to do something, Hector. Come on, Hector. I'm telling you, man, if you got your white girl sister, they say, I got me a Hector. He's going to work 18-hour days. We going to be straight. Come on, Hector. Better put in that work. She ain't going to work, Hector. You got to take her to work with you. Take her to work. Lawnmower, tell her to get to work. Lawnmower, get one of them damn edges. Come on, Hector.
That's crazy.
That's fucked up, man. That was some racist ass shit.
I think Joe was saying, like, she could be your landscape designer. Y'all can go into business together, and she can be your landscape designer. She can give houses curb appeal.
Hell yeah. And if she don't want to do that, Hector, you take her to the kitchen with you, man. Get her to wash them dishes. Come on, man. I know you're working at somebody's kitchen. Come on, Hector.
Hey, you know, I got kind of like a whole different opinion. You know what I'm saying?
Go ahead, Trey. What you got, Trey? How you going to help Hector?
It's like this. He ain't got nobody that ain't but himself. He created that movie. I understand what they was doing. But, you know, it's like this. When you take somebody independent from them and you make them dependent and they see you go do whatever it takes and all they got to do is they can be pretty, bro, you created that monster. And then now you get a divorce, bro. She gonna treat the shit out your soul, cuz. Straight up. Real talk. Like, that nigga, he created a monster. Ain't got nobody to blame but his fucking self. So, ain't gonna be no, how can I get her to go to work? She not gonna go to work. Period. Ain't no, let her do it unless he dies. Nope. It's his fault.
So, all right.
You got
this. Sorry, bro. All right, this slide. This is how I feel. Thank you for listening to Inside the Cave, Hector. I tell you listen because you were very detailed, and I remember that conversation CB was talking about the scenario if he was to get divorced and how his $30 plus an hour salary would be reduced down to $9 an hour from marriage and the children. That being said, Hector, the first thing Joe said, try getting a job, starting up your own business. If that's not working, Hector, if that's not working, what Trey said definitely is an issue because you definitely created this problem. Now, the only other game that you got left, the only other card you have left to play in your pocket is, hey, look, baby, two incomes are better than one. And we can do a whole lot more if it was two incomes coming in this door than just one. And it's just that simple. It don't matter if it's part-time income or sometime income, or she creates her own little hustle, you know. But you have to let her know that y'all a team and that y'all are in it together. It's not a you thing. It's not a her thing. It's a we thing. It's a team us thing. And there's no shame, and she shouldn't feel offended by bringing a couple coins to the table. That's it. Even if she keeps them for herself, it's something. That's my opinion. That's my opinion.
Period. I can't even believe we just let you talk. You ain't even married. Boy, hush. Who's next?
I know about money though. I know income coming in is a good thing.
Everybody ain't.
You know what I'm saying? That's how polygamous does it. Polygamous tells his wife, say, hey, baby, look, that's a third income coming in.
Boy, as another single man, Ro, what
now, even without living that as the lifestyle.
Say again.
What would you change about what he just said, Ro? Since he got it wrong.
Well, I like what Trey said. Trey said he created the monster. I'm not going to be as brutal. What I'm going to lean on is how he can get his situation right. Now, if she's not been working since the kids was school age, that means that she at least has 10 to 12 years of not working. You can't change that. And in all honesty, she should be offended. Because at the end of the day, race, culture aside, if the man chose to let the woman stay home to raise the children, then you got to go out there and make it happen, family. Now, peep game. I get it. You're struggling. I know it's difficult to make ends meet, but you got to try something else. You got to try to get full-time employment because guess what? At the end of the day, whether you have her or not, you still got to work. And once you chose to get married and have kids with her, that's what you chose to do. So a lot of men say nowadays that getting married is a bad deal for a man because of this reason. Because now you have, no matter the kids is gone, you still have two people to take care of, you and her. Because here's the thing, what if she couldn't work? What if she got injured? What if she had some type of disability? So if you're the able body and you chose to make this life for your family, bruh, you got to try to make them two part times at one. You, if you need to go back to school, you got to get some type of bigger training or whatever the case. You can't be looking to your wife to say, oh, it's your job to go out and support us now. Because where you lost me at was, now I will agree with Sly, two is better than one, but that's not what he said. He said, you go out and work and I stay home. Unless I read it wrong. Did I read it wrong?
It seemed like he resent her for not even trying to, you know, even pitch in or do whatever. So it's like he want to make her pay for it or something. That's why I'm like, bro, it's not at work. You shouldn't have told her that they were going to be Gucci. You know what I mean?
Now, exactly. A real woman
about her family is going to be like, nah, we doing, nigga, we go eat. We used to live like this. So this is how we going to fucking live. That's what a real woman do. So I saw his wife.
And how about this?
But it's her fault anyway, though.
But peep this, though. Men work. I don't know where these Negroes, I don't know about the stay-at-home dad.
No, it ain't about me and work, you know what I'm saying? Because there's been times that I done lost my fucking job, you know what I mean, pig. But guess what, while I'm looking for work, I'm taking care of house and home, you know what I'm saying? I'm cooking, I'm cleaning, like, she ain't got to do shit if she out there. But guess what, when I'm back to working again, you know, like, when different shit, you get laid off, shit beyond your control, whatever the case may be. Niggas, yeah.
I get that happens. That ain't what he's saying, though. He
right, I know that he stayed home. I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt on that one. You get what I'm saying? I'm giving him the benefit of doubt and even saying, hey, look, you know what? Buddy probably that's like, look, I just need you to work this part-time gig for X amount, or, you know, work this gig for at least, you know, 6 months while I'm working this, or while I do steady, because just like I feel you, yes, everybody know education is the key. Go pick up a skilled trade, bro. It's guaranteed work no matter where the fuck you go. But when you do that, you need time and you need money. And if she's not even willing to pitch in there, that's not an option for him, dude. That's what I'm saying. That selfishness is something that he created. He allowed and he just basically helped to make sure it festered. You know what I'm saying? Period.
But that didn't come just allowing her to stay home. I always believe, man, you knew what you married. You knew she wasn't no ride or die. You knew, that's
exactly.
Why,
that's what I'm saying. You got nobody to blame but herself.
Exactly.
And I mean, you know, thank him for being a listener, but, you know, he used the motherfuckers being real, right? He used to be all, you know what I'm saying, letting it be known. Like, I ain't gonna sugarcoat it, so fuck it. Look, real talk. It's your problem. You did it. Fucking deal with it, bro.
Hopefully, man, look here. Hector. Besides all that, you ain't gonna get no better advice than you get from Joe Dirt, all right? Hector, if she don't wanna work and she Mexican, you send her ass back to the old country. All right, Hector? Get a goddamn job then. She ain't gonna wanna go back, Hector. She ain't gonna have to climb that wall. She ain't gonna have to swim. Hey, I'm telling you, Hector. She don't wanna go back to the old country. She ain't gonna get that job, Hector. That threat out there.
Well, why did she get quit from here to there, cuz? What the fuck? Cubans that swim, nigga, not Mexicans, bro. And Hector, he could be from Puerto Rico.
And where you from? She ain't gonna wanna go back. Put that threat out there, Hector.
He's a rotten ass dude, man.
Hey, that's real. That's real advice, Hector. You take that shit to the bank.
Hey, you tell her you can do bad by your damn self, Hector, and mean it.
Hey, cuz, look, it's cheaper to keep her. All I'm going to say is...
Not in this case, Trey. No.
I'm going to jump on Ro right now. Ro said it best. You ain't married. Shut your ass up.
Wait a minute. Trey ain't married either? Oh, hell no.
No, man. Trey scared to pull that trigger. I told that nigga what to do. I told you what to do, Trey. You bullshit.
I'm speaking from experience. No, real talk though. I'm speaking from experience, right? Let's, like, on some real shit. Let's try to help the brother. And I'm dead ass serious. Stop looking. Look, you 18, 20 years in now, bro. ain't no looking to the left. She ain't the one. So you got to ride out, man. You got to get it out here and get it out. You live, bro. Legally.
Okay. Did he do that? Like he said, though, kid's not all the way grown, right? So, like, legitly, he finna get raped, bro. And you can tell he love her. It's a lot of resentment there. First off, if you really trying to help them, first thing they need to do, dinosaurs, nigga. No, but real talk, if you really trying to help them, cuz first thing he need to do is fucking get some counseling with him and his chick, bro. It's something wrong there.
Yeah,
it's
man,
a lot of business.
How the fuck he finna get shit costs money, Trey. Or it costs insurance, and you gotta have a job to have both of them fucking things.
Hey, guess what? I can tell you one of the main things that's not going on in their motherfucking relationship, because he was like, I told her to do this, I told her to do that, she told me no. Nigga, they ain't got
All right. Hey, can we get back on track? Because let's remember, we in this a coronavirus episode. He locked up with her ass anyway somewhere.
Right.
He gonna have to learn.
2 weeks, so figure that shit out. In 2 weeks, figure that shit out.
Send her back to the old country. Yeah. I'm telling you.
That's it. Next subject.
Well, he disappeared to the old country.
Yeah, hey, the flights is cheap right now too, Hector. I'm telling you.
You can send her back in style.
And then take your check.
He get said you send her back in style. You stupid as hell.
And you send her and the kids, Hector. Not just her. Send the kids too. That way you can
extra pressers on the plane.
Be by yourself. You be by yourself.
Now, what if they both American, though?
Come on, what name like Hector? Hector is not American.
He can still be American.
He basically said it don't matter if...
He said he don't matter. Just send him back.
I'm just fucking with you, Hector. Don't come find me. But real talk, Hector, if she don't want to work, man, you got to get rid of him.
No,
you can't sell a beast of Chavez to you.
He down in Virginia. All he gotta do is grab a lawnmower and an edger. He be
Alexandria, Virginia. Is that military town, Virginia? Is that military town?
No, not Alexandria.
I know it's warm a lot, and they got a lot of grass.
That's what I'm saying. Y'all call me racist,
but that's the
thing. I think I'm joining the boat. I'm saying, look, his name ain't gotta be Hector to go make some money. You said it racially. I said. Landscaping is the shit. Look, bro.
If I showed up on your doorstep and Hector showed up on your doorstep, you gonna get Hector to work.
You gonna try to pay him $5 to do a whole lot of shit that you don't want to do.
My landscape dude is black.
Yeah, to Hector come along. Hey, I'm sorry, man. Times is hard. You got the coronavirus.
And Hector say he can do everything your landscaping dude doing. For $15, you gonna go with dude for $15 a week.
You gonna cut the brother man for the other man, see?
No, that ain't me.
Hey, you
bro,
know
bro,
me.
Bro is not gonna, yeah, right, bro. Yeah, Ro pro black, man. He ain't.
Okay, Ro gonna not go with the Hispanic dude, right. But he gonna go back to the black dude and be like, hey man, I need you to do some more for this money I'm paying.
No, I don't do that either. Man, I'd be like, you charge? Yeah, what you charge, bro? All right, make sure you do what you say. Man, that's how I rock out. Matter of fact, my guy, actually, people talk bad about him. Be like, oh, man, I don't use him no more. I'd be like, man, me and Sylvester good. That's his name, hey, Sylvester. Man. I say, he come through, take care of my
dog. It sound like a pretty good guy, man. It's a pretty good fucking guy. Pretty good fucking guy.
Right, I bet you. Right. He dark skinned too, ain't he?
Yeah, he dark as hell.
He a damn landscaper. What you think he is? He in the sun all damn day. Come on now.
Bro, he put fingerprints on charcoal. Like, he dark.
Hey, all right, so we helped Hector. We did help Hector. We gave Hector some good sound ass advice.
We told Hector what he already fucking knew. So we
reiterated it.
This nigga been living this shit.
Sly, you gotta tell the truth.
Yes, I gotta tell the truth real quick. I got two. They real quick ones too. So check it out, y'all. Here's Inside the Cage, Tell the Truth. What's up, ladies? I got a couple questions. And guys, I'm gonna need y'all to answer this because both of these questions have something to do with men. Ladies, tell the truth. In a long distance relationship, who should move? That's the question. In a long distance relationship, who should be the one to move? Now, I know it's a podcast co-host in here that had a similar situation. And mm-hmm. I remember his story. But that aside, who should move and why should they move?
I think it depends on the situation. It depends on the situation. Like, it could be like a job situation. You know, who making the money? You know, maybe it could be a temporary situation. You know, maybe somebody moving for a temporary reason. But if it's long term, you're going to be here, I'm going to be here. I think, you know, it goes back to, once again, it goes back to, you know, what's going to benefit y'all? What's for the best? You know, is it a money situation? You know, is this person's job better? That person that's going to move to you, do they have opportunities to get a job, or is it not going to have any opportunities? Yeah. It's what
benefits them.
You know, if it's a
Let me give you this scenario. Let's say your girl makes six figures, minimum 100,000, right? Easily. But she lives in an apartment. She has a good job, but she lives in an apartment. You live 40 miles away and you own your own house. Who moves?
I mean, but
she's
like,
she's closer to where she worked, but she's 40 miles away from your home.
Okay. Yeah. How much money I make?
You obviously make enough to afford a $275,000 house. So you at least gotta be in that, you know, in that ballpark somewhere, like
in the high 90s, 85,000.
If I stayed at her apartment, you
say
know,
that again.
If I stayed at her apartment, how far am I from my job?
You own your own house. Your girl has an apartment, but she makes six figures.
But if I stay, just listen. I just got a question. If I stay at her job, at her crib, say Monday through Friday, because that's what my work schedule is, right? How far am I from my place of employment if I'm at her crib?
Your place of employment is closer to where you live, so at least 40 miles away, and then, you know, closer to your home.
Right. So it's a wash no matter what. Like, y'all both, no matter if
both of your residents. Your resident is closer to your work, and her resident is closer to her work.
Okay. This lie is up in the air, man. That ain't fair on neither one of them. That's like, y'all need to figure it out between both of y'all. Because y'all.
Can she find work doing what she do where you stay? Like, if she come to the house, you know, where that, you know what I'm saying? Can she, is she able to, survive, I guess. You know what I mean? Like, fan work, making the same or more.
What I'm hearing is this is going to be a conversation. It's going to be a conversation.
No, this is actually easy. I don't know why y'all trying to make this difficult. This is real
easy. Go ahead, Ro.
Okay. The thing is that it's 40 miles, okay? And any real man doesn't want their wife commuting 40 miles. That's a rough drive, right? So I believe that you choose the area that has the best opportunity for the one that's moving to get comparable work. Sometimes the man has to move. But what I will say is that you commute, I mean, you date long distance for a little bit of time that y'all can build up the trust, right? And the man, if the man has to move, the man does not move in that apartment for a long period of time. To me, this is just me, not judging nobody. I believe that a man makes a home for his wife. So y'all can either purchase a house together or move into an apartment together. But I don't think you should move into her apartment long term if you have to move. And as far as him having a home, if he was not previously married, then I believe that she could move into that house. And you could, and if anybody knows anything about houses, you can put her on the deed with no problem. You hire a lawyer, $350, $400, get the lawyer to put her on a deed, and then let that woman make some adjustments to that house that she feels like that home is hers with you. But that's how you work. That's how you work a relationship, is that there has to be give and take on both sides, but the woman also has to allow the man to be a man. You get what I'm saying? So, you know, if he's a, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't, whatever his personal compromise is, it may be different than mine. He may be perfectly cool. He might be tired of his house. He might want to downsize. I don't know. But the point is that there is no one or the other. It has to be. Where's the best opportunity? Like, let's say there might not be a great opportunity for her to move, but she want to be with him. She's like, well, you don't real feel real comfortable with going moving, so I'll move up there with you. Or if he's like, well, I can't tear her away from everything that she knows, you know what I mean? She got a strong family base and all that stuff. You don't want to just tear her away from that. Go move with her. Even if you got to take a hit on the money, or you got to sell your house. If you in love, man, that's what you do.
But now, though, that's the thing, though. That's where my problem at. Like, and that's why I felt like I had to ask a couple of questions. Because the reason we're putting it in black and white, we're talking about a house and an apartment. Apartments come and go. House is supposed to be a home. I agree with you on that. So if you go do the home thing, she moved with him. But we're talking about a six-figure job. I understand the whole commuting thing, blase, skippity do, whatever, whatever. But at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? All that love shit don't pay the bills.
But if she makes six figures, you can buy a house where she worked in her area.
I understand all that, and that's a totally different scenario. It goes right back to, you want a man to be a man? I'm not going to move somewhere and make $20,000 less than what I'm accustomed to just because I'm in fucking love, bro. That's like a big jump these days, you know what I'm saying? And if you're trying to, like, look at it, or, like, we men, how, like, a man, you know how most of us were taught how to be men? Mm-hmm. That's not nothing that a man gonna do. I understand together shit.
No, but see,
that's totally different.
I disagree with you, though, bro, because a man can still date a woman that makes more money than him.
But look,
that's not the issue.
Depending on the, right, that's not, and I get that. But depending on the career field, say shorty a lawyer, and she in the biggest city, and the home is in a smaller place. But what he do, he making so much money because he in that smaller client. He moved to that bigger city. He not gonna be able to make the same deal. It's like, yo, it's literally, think about Hector, bro. They could have been so in love, and before they had kids, she probably had her own gig, and he, you know, had her money, and they was rocking. He probably thought he had him a down-ass chick. And then, boom, shit was gravy. Somebody always seemed to get comfortable when they went with the 50. I agree with you on the whole, look, they need to take their time. Date, you know, for a while. See how much, if this shit really gonna be true to heart, then do that shit. Do it together. Find a mutual point and say, hell.
That's all I'm saying.
I get that. But you can't ask this man to give up his home that he
broke. But you can't live life on what ifs.
But that's the thing, though. Everything, when you talk about marriage and you talk about relationships and you talk about a woman moving here, moving there, that's all we talking about is what if. Period. Nigga, you know just like
that. No, but you going in, but you going, But you going into, man, if I take a cut in pay and I'm making less than her, she gonna get because she gonna get all like nigga, you ain't.
No. I ain't saying she'll get like that. But you got some men out there that'll start resenting the woman. I used to be able to do this. I used to be able to do that, but because I moved here,
but that's some weak.
Hell, I can. But
that's some weak ass shit though.
Goes back to that. What if
he needs to date somebody in his own city then? And he don't need to be dating her. if you that weak, then you don't need to be dating no six figure chick.
So the man.
The man makes a home for the wife, home for the woman,
or he takes the L, whichever distance wise or money wise, and he moves in with her.
No. So I'm not saying totally that, Sly. What I was saying was is that it. I'm not saying he should move. What I'm saying is if the opportunity happens to be better for both of them in her spot, all I'm saying is that they need to get something together, because I do know this. No man should ever move in with a woman, but I understand you might have to do it temporarily, because no man should have a woman have the power to be able to say, "Oh, motherfucking get out." You know what I'm saying? So as a man, you should always have equal, or you should be the homeowner, or you know what I mean, the person who can say,
okay.
Now, don't get me wrong, if y'all get into a spat, she called the police, nigga, you getting put out. But I'm just saying, I just hate when I see men sitting on a curb with a Giant Eagle bag and they Jordans talking about, nigga, come pick me up. Like, that's some weak shit.
I got you, bro. I got you. Thank you.
But if you do bring a woman into your home, it is your job to allow her to put her stamp. You can't have a bachelor pad, move a chick in and be like, oh, no, you can't move that. No, I don't want you moving that over there. Like, you can't do that. Then you don't want to be with nobody. You get what I'm saying? So you got to make sure you really want to be with this chick. And if you can't command a relationship as a man, just because she makes six figures, then you need to date broke bitches then. Because any nigga that's dating somebody, go ahead.
You don't downgrade and date no broke bitch, you know what I'm saying?
So I got one more, y'all. I got one more so we can get out of here.
Right,
And it might end up going right back into this conversation. Should the woman pay for the vacation 100% of the time, or pay something on the trip? Or should the woman wait for her guy to have the money to pay for their vacation together? That was submitted. That Ladies Day question. I mean, I'm sorry, not Ladies Day. That Inside the Cave Tell the Truth, Ladies Tell the Truth question was submitted by a subscriber by Donna. So Donna, we're reading your question and we're gonna give you an answer. Should the woman pay for a vacation 100% of the time, or pay something on the trip? Or should a woman wait for her guy to have the money to pay for their vacation together? What you got on that, Trey?
Married or single? I mean, not single, married or boyfriend.
You know what? What she said, it doesn't say, she just say wait. Should the woman wait on her guy to have the money to pay for their vacation?
So that sounds like boyfriend, girlfriend. Okay, go ahead, guys.
Okay, dude, I feel like that. It just goes back to what we've been discussing. Is she a down bitch? If he a down nigga? If they got it,
straight up, like, without bringing up the last conversation, what's the answer to this one? Like, first thing off your head,
I feel like if they in it to win it, and she got the money to support something like that, or like she even said, or put something on it, which makes me feel like he done came with a third or a half. If she truly honestly know that's all that he could bring to the table, she taking one for the team. That's what she gotta do. You know what I'm saying? So, that's it. That's her life. But that's what she picked.
But and she gotta
on
do
the flip
it.
Side, if she be a dick around. Well, and she gotta do it what?
No, I was going to say,
I feel like ain't nothing wrong with it in the sense
respect.
Of,
She got to do it with respect, though. Okay.
Yeah. Not like
man, I'm agreeing like with. I'm agreeing with Trey. Because if she got it, she got it.
Don't get me wrong. It's okay.
Yeah. No doubt. It's certain things. Certain women do well. Let's be clear. Like some women vacation well. Like that's their shit. They know they going on three to five trips a year, and they know that they taking their man on two of the trips, right? Period. And it don't matter if it's you or her girlfriends or the family members or family reunion or wedding or whatever. They like booking their shit and paying for it and getting it out the way, right? So if you know this is the type of woman that you're dealing with, as soon as you say, hey, I got those days off work, or yes, I'm available to go, you know, they're probably already halfway done searching for the trip, or they're ready to book immediately. So let that person handle it. Now, that being said, if they're more conservative with it, like, yeah, we're gonna take a vacation, we should look to going someplace, I'm gonna let you handle that. I'm gonna let you, Trey, handle that. Where we going, I'm gonna let Ro, I'm gonna let you handle that. You decide where we going and just let me know the dates and I'm cool with that. Guess what? You paying for it, and you should pay for it, because she's saying, hey, I'm okay with whatever you decide. Just let me know the dates. And whatever you decide, you pay for it, and you pay for all of it. Period. And that's the way I view it, and that's the way I hear it. And it works. Like, I refuse to argue over money, and I'm damn sure not gonna ever argue over a fucking vacation. Period. Like, that ain't what vacation for. Vacation for to be stress free. You shouldn't be stressing on a fucking vacation. So I never argue over no fucking money.
Well, there again lies who's best suited to pay for the trip. If he out buying, you know, being selfish and buying things for himself, and really can truly afford to put something on the trip, and he ain't doing it, then he don't deserve to go nowhere. But if he's a hardworking man and ain't got the ends to treat on a trip, and she does, she's better with her finances. One, she need to help him get better with his finances. But more importantly, if she want to go on a trip, there's nothing wrong with paying for a woman paying for a trip. If that's your man, if y'all ride it, like Trey said, y'all ride or die, this is what y'all do. Then yeah, pay for the trip, go on a trip. But don't be on the way on the trip saying, or telling your girlfriend, I had to pay for this trip again, this broke ass nigga. He don't never pay for no trips. Like, come on, you can't do that either. That's what I meant by the respect piece. And we both know that there's women out there that do stuff like that.
Yeah.
They pay for the trip just to throw it back in your face. That's not cool. If you gonna pay for the trip, nobody should know you paid for the trip other than your man.
Yeah. And that's the answers, Donna. Those are the answers right there. Speak up. Speak up, Trey. I can't hear you. You're breaking up.
If y'all down for it, then that's what's supposed to go down.
That's better. All right.
Is that so better?
Yeah, much better.
If y'all down for it, and that's what's supposed to go down. You know what I mean? All I'm saying is, when you with a motherfucker, you supposed to be with a motherfucker that's going to raise your credit score. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
3 years, you like, damn, this bitch made my credit score jump 75 motherfucking points just because she helping me to make sure I pay my bills instead of saying fuck that shit. Or, you know, we doing this and we doing that, and it's because she's better with finances, for instance. Just like you said, if that's that motherfucking strength, yes, you help, you know, take care of the finances in the household. But if you see your man weak in that area, you teach a motherfucker, you help him.
Absolutely.
Because that's what it's about. You know what I'm saying? If y'all got true that kind of relationship, ain't nothing wrong with you paying for no motherfucking trip. Because like you said, ain't nobody gonna fucking know but you and him. And if you got a chick that's trying to teach you some shit like that, it ain't even gonna come up. It's gonna be like, nigga, can you get them days off? Yeah. Okay, motherfucker, we going to motherfucking Niagara Falls that damn weekend. All
right,
nigga, we
pay. Right.
Like, okay, shit.
So Donna, that go your answer right there. Answers, you know, pick which one you like and roll with it. You know, hold it, stick to your guns, and that's what it is. You know, do what you want, do what you mean, and mean what you want. That's all I can say. You know, this is Inside the Cave, in Cast Corners, or Tell the Truth. Please email us at InsideTheCavePodcast@gmail.com. For my co-host, Roland, Trey, International D, Joe Dirt that jumped all night, CB that's not here, Drew that's not here, my cousin Lamar that's not here tonight. You know, we back, baby. We're back.
Big dog, baby. Big dog. Don't forget Big Dog.
Can't forget big the fucking dog. Big dog. Big dog, back baby, together. You know what I'm saying? It's Inside the Cave Podcast with our rowdy, rowdy friends, brother. And we're coming back. You're coming back. Hey, CB, we missed your last night, man. You know, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry. I love you. I love you, dog. We love you, too. And maybe the rest of them don't, but you all right with me. I don't care what they say.
All right. Thanks for tuning in. We catch y'all ass. We catch y'all.
We catch y'all ass next week during this coronavirus shit. You know what I'm saying? Tune in to Indie Central Radio. You know what I'm saying? The Indie Central Podcast. You know, look out for the advertisements that's gonna be popping up on all social media since we got all of y'all sitting at home. You know, and remember, it's Inside the Cave Podcast. Inside the Cave Podcast. Inside the Cave Podcast. Say that shit 3 times in your bathroom mirror while you at home in the dark. Not candy, man, motherfucker. Say Inside the Cave Podcast. 3 motherfuckers.
Inside the Cave.
You did say you wanted to be in, right?